Hello and welcome to the second part of the 24th installment of my Pokémon Generation 3 ROM hacking series. The focus of this tutorial is to learn all about the intricacies of Overworld sprites and how to replace and add your own custom sprites. To do this, we'll be utilizing a tool called Overworld Manager by Kimonos. This video will be broken down into the following segments. What are palette IDs and palette slots and how do they work? What's the big deal with palette slot 0x0? And how do I properly use newly added palette IDs? Every Overworld sprite has a palette of 16 colors. The first is used as the background or transparency color, while the other 15 are used to draw the sprite. These distinct palettes can be identified with what we call a palette ID. For example, the player's palette ID is 0x1100, so the ID 0x1100 refers to the combination of the 16 colors used in the player's palette. Simple. The interesting thing about the original Overworld sprites is that there are only a total of 18 different palette IDs for them to work with. This means that every single Overworld sprite, all 151 of them, share the exact same 18 combinations of colors. If you scroll through the Overworld sprites, you can see that completely different sprites may reference the exact same palette ID. Now let's talk about palette slots. I'll try to illustrate these on screen as best as I can. There are a total of 16 palette slots in the game, those being slots 0x0 through 0xf. A palette slot contains a palette ID. However, a palette slot cannot contain more than one palette ID at any time. When an Overworld sprite is within the player's field of view, it needs to be drawn on the screen. In order for the game to draw the sprite onto the screen, it needs to know what colors to use for that sprite. To figure out which colors to use, it loads the sprite's palette ID from whichever palette slot is assigned to that sprite. So for example, the player has the slot 0x0 assigned to him, so when the game needs to draw the player onto the screen, it loads the palette ID from slot 0x0, which allows the player to be drawn with the correct colors. When an Overworld sprite is no longer within the player's field of view, the game quits loading the sprite's palette ID from its respective palette slot. There's no need to load it, since the game doesn't need those colors anymore. Another detail about palette slots is that 14 of them are what we call static, and 2 of them are what we call dynamic. Every slot excluding slots 0x0 and 0xa are static. In other words, slots 0x1, 0x2, 0x3, 0x4, 0x5, 0x6, 0x7, 0x8, 0x9, 0xb, 0xc, 0xd, 0xe, and 0xf are all static. This means that these slots load a palette ID the moment you start the game, but they never let it go. Once a palette ID has been loaded into one of these slots, it will stay there for the rest of eternity. Dynamic slots, on the other hand, are able to unload their palette IDs and load new ones while the game is being played. As you can imagine, this allows for a lot more flexibility than the static slots do. There are only two of these dynamic slots, which are slots 0x0 and 0xa. The main issue we're going to tackle in this tutorial is the inconsistency between the amount of palette IDs that exist versus the amount of palette slots that exist. You may recall that in Fire Red, there are 18 palette IDs but only 16 palette slots. In Emerald and Ruby, there are 30-some palette IDs but only 16 palette slots. Here's where the problem comes in. If 14 of these slots are static, then the same exact 14 palette IDs are going to be occupying them throughout the entire game. Only two slots, 0x0 and 0xa, have the ability to dynamically swap palette IDs. This implies that those extra 20 or so palette IDs that will eventually need to be used to draw sprites onto the screen are limited to only those two dynamic slots. Seems like we have a space issue, doesn't it? What if we want to draw three NPCs onto the screen, but none of them have their palettes stored in one of the static slots? There are only two dynamic slots to work with, so I guess it's a race to see who can fill in those slots the quickest or something. Obviously, this wouldn't work. What would happen is two of the sprites would be drawn correctly, but the third wouldn't be drawn with the correct palette. It would have to borrow one of the other sprites' palettes, which would make that sprite look miscolored like a zombie or something. So what's the solution? Well, there isn't one, but there is a way to work with the system with limited results, which we can see by looking at what FireRed does with its extra palette IDs. The static slots hold the IDs 0x1100 through 0x1113. Therefore, we can have as many overworld sprites as we want drawn onto the screen as long as they all share these 14 palette IDs. The extra two IDs are only given to one sprite each. Sprite 108 is given ID 0x1114, and Sprite 151 is given ID 0x1115. You'll also notice that they are both signed to the same palette slot, 0xA, which happens to be dynamic. So what if we want to draw both of these sprites onto the screen at the same time? The answer is we can't. What we can do is draw one of them onto the screen. This will fill slot 0xA with its palette ID. Then, once that sprite is out of the field of view, palette slot 0xA suddenly becomes empty again. Now we can load the other sprite's ID into slot 0xA and draw it onto the screen. See how this works? You just have to be careful that you don't have too many overworld sprites near each other if they all rely on the same palette slot but they have different palette IDs. But what about slot 0x0? I mentioned that this slot is also dynamic. Why don't we just use it like we use slot 0xA and keep switching out palette IDs? The answer is that slot 0x0 is a little bit special. The player uses that slot, and guess what? The player is almost always being drawn onto the screen, so there's no practicality in pretending like it can be used the same way that slot 0xA can be used. Not only that, but there's also something very dangerous about slot 0x0. In part 1 of this tutorial, the original player's sprite was overwritten by my Shaman sprite. You probably didn't notice, but the palette ID was updated along with it. The original palette is still in the list, but a new ID, 0x1116, was added to the list and assigned to the sprite. This new palette stores Shaman's custom colors. The dangerous part about it is that there's something else that uses slot 0x0, which you never in a million years would have expected. It's the little icons that pop up over the characters' heads. The exclamation point, the arrow pointing towards a door, the question mark, the smiley face, etc. All of these icons had their palettes changed without us even being aware at the time we did it, meaning we just corrupted some of the game's graphics. See how complicated overworld sprite editing can get? But fear not, FireRed hackers, because there's a pseudo-solution out there. A Poke community member named Navinatix, or Navinatox, or however it's pronounced, created and released a patch which makes all 16 palette slots dynamic. There are no longer any static slots, just dynamic ones. This means you won't be restricted to struggling with the original 16 IDs plus whatever extra palette IDs you added. No more strategic NPC placing to accommodate for only 2 dynamic palette slots. You've got 12 more slots to dynamically load and unload IDs to and from, which takes essentially all of the worry out of overworld sprite editing. A link to this patch can be found in the description of this video. Unfortunately for Ruby and Emerald hackers, there isn't a patch like this for you. At least not yet. If in the future there ever is one released, please let me know in case I miss it so I can add it in the video's description as well. There's only one more thing I want to cover. Under the palette info section, the used palettes label tells us how many palette IDs exist in the ROM. Currently there are 19, which consists of the original 18 and Shaman's additional palette. The available palettes label tells us how many more palette ID spaces are available to add. Remember how ID 0x1115 is specific to the big ship? What if we were to replace the ship with a custom sprite or just remove it altogether? Then the ship's palette ID would no longer be needed since not a single other overworld sprite uses it. If something like this happens, it's a good idea to delete that extra palette that's not being used so we can free up some space. To do this, click Actions, Palette Cleanup. This will delete all palettes that aren't being used by a single overworld sprite. That's everything I plan to discuss in the second part of this tutorial. Hopefully you all learned something valuable from this, and if you have any questions, please feel free to ask either over at Poke Community or right here in my video's comment section. Thank you so much for being my audience, and I'll be back in the 25th installment of this series.